Now, we will see that Raoult's law is a special case of Henry's law. See, in Raoult's law, we saw that the total pressure, this is our Raoult's law, that P total is equal to x1 p1 naught plus x2 p2 naught. And we know they have usual meanings. This is the mole fraction in solution. Okay? This is also the mole fraction in the solution form. Okay. Now what happens? If I assume that one of them is so volatile that it has become a gas. Okay? So one of it is so volatile that it has become a gas. And our Henry's law says what? It says that P is equal to KH into X, where X is what? X is again the mole fraction of the of that gas in the solution. So mole fraction of gaseous component in solution. And P is what? P is obviously the pressure of the gaseous component.
Of only the gaseous
Only the gaseous component. We had been using the Henry's law for the solubility of the gases in the liquid, right? Gases in the liquid. Now, if I assume that one of that has absolutely vaporized, and one of them is not has not vaporized. Okay, so say this does not vaporize at all. Fine. The second one that does not vaporize at all. So what happens? This P2 naught is 0, correct? So this P2 naught is 0. We understand that. I say component 2 does not vaporize.
X2 will also be 0.
Does not vaporize. Wait. It's not that X2 is 0, it is because P2 naught will become 0.
Why, when there is no.
X2 is in solution form. Rather, X2 will become very high if it does not vaporize. But P2 naught will be absolutely zero if we do not consider it volatile.
A component two does not vaporize. That was vaporized.
No, it does not
X1
vaporize.
will be 0.
It does not vaporize. Correct? Therefore, P2 naught is equal to 0. So, therefore, Raoult's law becomes what? P total is equal to x1 p1 naught. Now see, what we mean by absolutely vaporized is that a very small fraction of it remains here and its p1 naught must be very high. You understand? Since it is so vaporizable, so what happens? It hardly anything will remain, as we just saw in case of that ethane thing. Okay, hardly anything will remain, but this one will become very high, correct, for one of the components if it is highly volatile, correct? So what happens? And so this is not contributing to the pressure, and this is contributing everything to the pressure, correct? Now this cannot be zero. Even with a very small amount here, it is capable of creating a huge amount of pressure up because of its volatility, correct? So I get that all the pressure P total is P1 naught into x. So what happens? My Rolle's law becomes Henry's. Now compare equation 2 and equation 3. Comparing 2 and 3, we get, what do we get? Comparing 2 and 3, we get that P1 naught is equal to KH. It becomes a single component kind of thing. Okay? You understand that? But ultimately we are bothered about the total pressure above the fluid in both. Total pressure above the solution has to be considered, right, in both. In Rolle's law here, because if I consider only one, what will you do with this? In Henry's, this pressure is what? This is total pressure. So I have to be comparing with the total pressure, right? I have to be comparing with the total pressure. And you'll have to assume that the volatility of this component is nothing compared to the other one. But try to understand, it is partial pressure, but you do not consider the vaporization of the second component.
But when x is very small,
but P1 naught is very high, very, very high. It'll give you a large P total. It's very, very high compared to any liquid that you come across. The gases, see, even otherwise, gases are the most volatile, no? At the room temperature, while you are still a liquid, gases have already vaporized, no? So they are more volatile. They have to be more volatile. Which? This is total. When you are dealing with the Henry's law, you take it as the total pressure. Because you do not take the other component. You do not take the other component into account. Though I said there will be, that component also should creep in. But that will lead to a very, very small amount of pressure buildup. This is how you find out the total pressure. Even in Henry's law, this is what the total pressure is. We do not take the other component at all. In Henry's law, whenever you are doing the calculations, you never ever consider the other component. You understand? This is definitely partial pressure, but its contribution to the whole is so much that you start taking it as total pressure. Okay. And you'll find if you sort of take the KH of that as P1 naught, then you'll find out that value will be minuscule. The other component will be very, very small. Maybe in a question or two, you can solve that. What is the value of KH here? Take the value of KH, you'll get to know.
0.5.
Value of KH.
For what? This is the question.
Henry's. See for helium, it is 145 kilobar. okay, it's for helium, it is 145 kilobar, and you come to this. Now let us do that comparison, it will become clearer. For chloroform it is 200 mmHg. It is 200 for chloroform, that is CHCl3. Your value of P naught is how much? 200 mmHg. Now 200 mmHg is how much? 3 bar? Less than 3 bar? 200 mmHg is how much? 76 mmHg is 1 atmosphere. Correct. So this is approximately I'm saying, just we are trying to calculate 3 bar. Fine. Now let us come to a gaseous component and calculate and find its KH value. Can you show me? The KH value. Flip it back. Yes. Let us come to helium. Here the KH value is what? 145 kilobar. 145,000 bar. You see, why they are not taking the contribution of the other one? This is at least how many times? 50,000 times more than that. That is the kind of volatility of the gases. So even maybe some millimoles or some, okay, even 10 to the power minus 4 moles are capable of producing a pressure of say 15-20 bars. You understand? Bar. This is in bar. It was 145 kilobar. So even if I have maybe 1 into x is equal to 1 into 10 to the power minus 4, then also this gas will contribute to 14.5 bar. While if this is say even 100% or 1, it is contributing only 3 bar. Why I'm saying 1? Because gas is very small. Then also. It is of the order of 10 to the minus 4, so the other component will be 1. This approximately tending to 0, so 1 minus say 1, 0.1 millibar is 1. So while this is contributing 3, this is contributing 14.5. So this is still contributing 5 times that, even with such a small mole fraction. And that's why in this, you actually neglect, when you are doing the Henry's law, you neglect the contribution of the other component fully. Okay. So that's why I have started by talking about the P total. Okay. Saying that this is say considered to be approximately absolutely non-volatile, then it becomes Henry's law. No?